Use promo code BloodyRhino for 15% off any order at Bloody Gaming. Link in description. Use promo code RedRhino for 10% off at PulseLabs.com. Link in description. Hey, what's going on, everybody? RedRhino Music here, bringing you another video. Today we're on a game called KartKraft. This just became available for early access on Steam as of a couple days ago, probably 4 days ago. I played a little bit of it so far just to get my controls right and everything, because, you know, it's a simulator, so you kind of have to tweak some settings around. And I haven't gotten them just right yet, but we're doing all right. It's good enough for now. Anyways, KartKraft is a go-kart racing slash karting, whatever you prefer to call it, simulator. So rather than it being like Project Cars, where like 3% of the game is a go-kart race, this is 100% go-kart racing. And I think that's cool. I like the idea of there being more than two or three different disciplines of sim racing. Because, I mean, you got GT3 out the wazoo on every sort of simulator game. You've got LMP type of stuff on most of them as well. iRacing is ovals. And then dirt, that's rally stuff. But now there's a singular focus on go-karts. And I think that's cool. It's something different. So what we're going to do, actually, before we get started with any driving, I want to show you guys the customization in this game. Now, it's not really there yet. There was a little message at the beginning when I started up the game, and I'll put that on the screen right now. Just explaining, like, the whole process of what's going to be like. It's going to be rough, the guy says, and the dev team says, but they're planning stuff already. They're open for advice and suggestions, and that's cool. I like when people are, like, upfront like that, and they'll be like, yeah, this game's not gonna be 100% right now, but we're listening. So I like that. Anyways, if you go to shop, we have a bunch of different manufacturers, and I'm pretty sure these are just chassis. I don't know if this is a full, like, build. Actually, let's take a look. Aero X30 is, like, our class that we're in, so I guess, yeah, they're all pre-built for X30 class. There's a bunch of different classes, I think. I saw it somewhere, I don't remember where. But this is our cart, and this is one thing I wanted to look at real quick to point out to you guys. Now, if we go to my cart, we click on it, and pick this setup. Look at all of this stuff, and I assume this is all either going to be customizable or tunable in the future. I don't think it is yet. I can't really figure it out. And I don't know why they have two different names for these things, some of them, but it's whatever. I don't really know what this does. And at the bottom right there, you see like a white square with an R. I don't know what that actually means. It's cut off for me. So who knows what that means. But if we look at this, we got stub axle, wheel hub, rim, chassis, nose cone. Why does it keep jumping back? I don't know what that is. Okay. Rim, chassis, nose cone, steering column, tie rod. Why is it fighting me? I wasn't doing that before. Steering wheel, data logger, seat, Nassau panel, which is like this nose thing. Side pod, bumper, engine, bearing carrier, axle, pedal, fuel tank, master cylinder, brake caliper, brake rotor, tire, camera, engine mount, carburetor, airbox, exhaust, sprocket, torsion bar, chain, water pump. And that's about it. I don't know why he was fighting me on that. That's a little weird. I wasn't doing that earlier. Anyways, but I think that's all going to be, like, customizable or at least tunable in the future. And I think that's awesome. Driver, you get suits and gloves and all that stuff. I picked the red guy. There was a blue, and I think there was a green or black suit you could get. I don't remember. Picked red for obvious reasons. The tent, I picked a blue one. There's a green one that you could pick. I don't really know what the tent is. They describe it as, like, oh, you need to get a spot to get out of the weather and, like, tune your car or whatever, so who knows what that is. And then gear, you pick this drone, and then when you do photo mode or watch, like, replays, I think it's all shot from your drone, which is awesome. We'll take a quick look at the settings for you guys. I assume you're mostly interested in input, so you get these basic presets. I went with the Thrustmaster T500 RS, even though I have a TX, technically. And then I have it binded to all this stuff, so whatever. These are my input settings as of right now. I never understood the combined pedals, like, I don't know what that would be for. I have 900 degrees of rotation. I tried 180 and it didn't actually really improve anything for me, so I want to leave that alone. These are these settings. I don't know if you part of me kind of wants the minimum force, like, on par with the feedback gain. But I don't know, we'll get out of that. Game settings, yada yada, you can change, like, your field of view and all that stuff. I left it alone. And yeah, we're gonna go race. Right now, I think that's all that's available is practice. Quick race is in that letter thing that was at the beginning. They mentioned quick race, then they mentioned VR support, and then they've mentioned online. So I don't know what their timeline thing is for all that stuff, but we'll see what happens. Anyways, you get three tracks. My favorite is PFI. The other ones are alright though. We're gonna do sunny. I was getting some frame issues with overcast and vehicle class, you could see. That's where I was seeing it. So I guess we're X30, but then there's gonna be some other ones in the future. Now, this car has no gears, so I'm not gonna be shifting or anything. We're just gonna be going. The other thing that's a little tricky about this game is there's actually no reverse, because I mean, it's a go-kart. It doesn't have reverse, especially one with one gear. Join session. So what I want you to pay attention to right now is the sound and the graphics. Everything's beautiful. Everything's a crisp and sharp. I have this in 1440p on my monitor, even though I have a 4K monitor, and it still looks really good. Like, it doesn't lose any resolution, really. And, yeah, everything's insanely good looking, especially for a small team. I think it's a small team of developers. But listen to the sound. You get to backfire off this thing, and if you're wondering why it echoes like that, it's because we're actually technically in a garage. I can't look around, I don't think. But yeah, you can see it there. We're like in a tunnel thing. Also, the cameras are weird. You get the normal, like, basic camera. Then you get this basic camera, I guess. I wouldn't use this with a wheel. You get this, like, nose camera where you get to see the foot go down, which is also strange. You get this camera, it's like a GoPro on your shoulder, which is actually pretty cool. But if you pay attention, you can see, like, all of the suspension and stuff moving there, which is awesome. Then you get this one where you get like a close-up of it, which is cool. It's very detailed. Tires look great too, might I add. The fact that you can see like where they're made on the little like indent thing, it's awesome. The last camera is kind of weird. Anyways, let's get it. This thing is so loud. It sounds so good. I'm impressed with the sound of this game. When I was driving before, that was like the main thing I was really impressed by, besides these graphics. The game looks fantastic. Some frame drops, some stutters here and there, but it's literally 3 or 4 days old, so it's no big deal. Plus, I'm playing in ultra settings in 1440p. And recording on the same PC, which I don't normally do. Now, the thing with go-karts is they're much different to... I mean, they're not different to drive, but they're... they're very unique. Like, everything is very twitchy and, like, you gotta be really responsive. I don't know why it's hiccuping so much. It wasn't doing that before. I might have something running. Let's get back on the gas. Ooh, that's loud. I like it. Let's go zipping through here now. The thing with go-karts is it's so easy to, like, overcorrect or turn too much. So, I mean, what you see on my screen is all I'm doing with my hands. Like, I'm not turning more than that. And if you do turn more than that, you really get yourself into some trouble. And it's been a long time since I've driven go-karts. I had one in real life for a while, but not like this style. I had, like, one of those, like, off-roading style ones. But I would drive it in my, like, on the road and on the driveway and stuff, and I would get it sideways. I'd spray water and just get it loose. Oh, we have a fatality. Yeah, all of the other cameras don't really have function. Like, this one does, but not really, because I can't see anything to the other side of the cart if I had to see, like, a right turn like this one up ahead. See if I can put in a good lap, even though this lap's already shot. Ooh, boy, a little sideways there. The steering is so twitchy, and it's nothing against the game. It's just, like, a whole different type of racing for me. Like, I barely even do, like, open-wheel cars in anything else, like any other game. I'm mostly in GT3 myself. But it's a lot of fun just to whip around a little go-kart, and I feel like if there was online on this, it would be a lot of fun. And I was following this game for a while, too, and it went, like, silent for a while, and people were like, oh, I wonder what happened to it, and then here it is out of nowhere. We're gonna check out the pit. I don't really know where you do a pit stop at. We got some scales here. What the hell is this? Some weird smiley face thing on the side there. Hello, bystanders. Oh, we gotta do this. The sound is crazy. See, I really should be going wide to enter this uphill. But it's just so hard to, like, get this thing where you want it. Oh, I didn't leave the track that much. Come on, now. I'm definitely locking this thing up under braking, but... Anyways, I just wanted to take a quick look at this game and show you guys what's up. I think this game has a ton of potential. I don't want to do a review of it. This is certainly not a review video. And, I'm not gonna do a review until the game gets to full release, like, full launch release. As of right now, this game is pretty solid. As of being a couple days into early access, there's not much content here yet. I mean, it will hold you over, especially if you switch from games and you, like, in between some project cars or something like that, or iRacing or something, you wanna switch it up, get in a go-kart for a little while. There you go. So eventually you'll see some online, you'll see some races, you'll see more karts, and then eventually you'll have a full game. But this has been KartKraft. If you guys want to see more of this on the channel, make sure you hit that like button down below and let me know in the comments. Also, while you're down there, let me know what you think of the game so far. Let me know if you're interested in it or anything. Anyways, make sure you guys hit that subscribe button down below so you can get notified for when I upload new videos. Thanks for watching. See y'all next time. Peace.